Hello everyone, welcome to the daily prelims current affairs program brought to you by NEO IAS. Today is 17th of June 2018. The topics we will be dealing today are NABARD, vitamin D, cholera, regional rural banks, artificial limb manufacturing corporation of India. So the first topic for the day is NABARD. There was a research project for mapping the water atlas for 10 major Indian crops conducted by NABARD, and they submitted a report titled Water Productivity Mapping of Major Indian Crops. The report emphasized water productivity over land productivity. It is because 80% of the water resource is used by Indian agriculture. We all know that India is moving to be a water scarce country in the near future. So the need for water conservation is high, and that is the reason why NABARD has emphasized on water productivity, that is increased crop productivity per unit quantity of water. So that's all about the report. Now we will discuss about NABARD. NABARD stands for National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development. It is an apex financial institution which aims to monitor credit flow into the rural economy. It was established as per the report submitted by Committee to Review Arrangements for Institutional Credit for Agriculture and Rural Development. And the committee was headed by Sri B. Shivaraman. And as per the report, NABARD came into existence in the year 1982. Before that, the crediting of agriculture was the function of RBI, and refinancing function was the function of Agriculture Refinance and Development Cooperation. After NABARD came into existence, both this function has transferred to NABARD. NABARD is fully owned by Government of India. The main objective of NABARD is to uplift rural economy by increasing the credit for the upliftment of agriculture and rural non-farm sector. NABARD is headquartered. The headquarters of NABARD is located in Mumbai. The next topic is vitamin D. The news was that there was a study conducted by University of California saying that higher level of vitamin D will decrease the risk of breast cancer. So we will discuss more about vitamin D. Vitamins are of two types, water soluble and fat soluble. Water soluble vitamins are B and C, and the rest are fat soluble, including vitamin D. Vitamin D is also called sunshine vitamin because we will get vitamin directly from sunlight by synthesizing ultraviolet rays. Also, dietary sources are also available for vitamin D, but they are limited to some fishes and eggs. This vitamin D is responsible for intestinal absorption of calcium, magnesium and phosphate. Also, it is responsible for absorption of calcium. That is the reason why deficiency in vitamin D causes rickets. Rickets leads to soft bone and skeleton deformities. So, better quantity of vitamin D in the body will lead to stronger bones. The deficiency in vitamin D, it can be attributed to lifestyle. Due to the usage of sunscreen and walking all the day in air-conditioned room, etc., will hinder the production of vitamin D in our body. Also, there was a research saying that 90% of the students are vitamin D deficient. So for that reason, government has come up with a project called Project Dhoop. It is launched by Food Safety and Standard Authority and National Council of Education, Research and Training, NCERT. It aims to ensure maximum absorption of vitamin D among students by shifting the assembly time. Usually it was morning, now they are planning to shift, they are shifting it to the noon, in order to ensure maximum absorption of sunlight. The next topic is cholera. Cholera is a bacterial disease caused by a bacterium called Vibrio cholerae. It causes severe watery diarrhea and can lead to dehydration and consequently even death. It is majorly caused by eating contaminated food and water infected by this bacteria. And that is why it is most commonly seen in places of poor sanitation. It is majorly seen in Africa, South Asia and Latin America. It can be successfully treated with rehydration solution, and also with antibiotics. In order to fight this global menace, the World Health Organization has come up with a global strategy to reduce cholera deaths by 90%. The next topic is regional rural banks. What makes it an important topic is the government has decided to consolidate the process of regional rural bank. Currently, there are 56 regional rural banks, and after consolidation, it confined into 38 banks. So, more about regional rural banks. The regional rural banks are established as per recommendation of Narasimham Committee, and it is established under Regional Rural Bank Act 1976. The first regional rural bank is Pradhama Bank, which is based in Moradabad. And the intention behind establishment of regional rural bank is that it is established to meet the needs of rural areas. The major objectives of regional rural banks are to bridge the credit gap in rural areas. Also, it aims to restrict the outflow of rural deposits to urban areas. It also aims to increase rural employment generation activities. The regional rural banks are established by three entities, that is the center, the state, and a sponsored bank. Each regional rural bank is sponsored by a public sector bank. This public sector bank will aid and advise RRB in its functioning. As per an amendment in 2015, the share of these three entities, that is center, state, and the sponsored bank, should not be less than 51%. And also, as per the amendment, RRBs can raise their own fund by involving other stakeholders. But the share of center, state, and sponsored bank together should not be less than 51%. And the last topic for the day is Artificial Limb Manufacturing Corporation of India. It is a Miniratna category central public sector enterprises, which is registered under Companies Act 2013. It is placed under Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. It is completely owned by Government of India. It aims to benefit persons with disabilities by providing better quality aids and appliances for the disabled person at a reasonable price. It started its functioning in the year 1971, and it is headquartered in Kanpur. So that's all for today. For more facts and information, please go through our daily prelims current affairs material, which you can find it in the link attached below. Thanks for watching.